blessings, blessings, blessings. This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Saints of God, could someone stand to their feet and give the King of Glory a round of applause, please? Enter into his gates with what?
Thanksgiving.
That's right, that's right. So we're just going to give thanks. I turned on the news this morning and I saw some things that... It definitely looks like time is wrapping up closer and closer to the end. I don't know if you saw what I seen, but there's missiles flying in the sky right now. Saints of God, could somebody please give the Lord a hand clap. He's preserved us for one other day. We don't know what tomorrow will hold, but last week was powerful. By the grace of God and thanks to Dr. Mullins, we pushed back some stuff. But we got to keep pushing. We can't stop. Glory to God. Glory to God. Let's just open in prayer as we get ready. Stand in the presence of the Lord. Oh, dear Jesus, Spirit of the living God, we thank you, Holy Spirit, for this moment in time that you've preserved us and given us the opportunity to enter into your house once more. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. We were glad when they said unto us, we could freely go into the house of the Lord. So even as we come into the house of the Lord today, it's not a situation that we take for granted, dear Heavenly Father. It's a situation that we are appreciative of, dear Lord. A time and a place where we get to just meet with you once more. And we know that we could pray in our homes, dear Heavenly Father. But help us to even understand just the meaning, the purpose of church, the ecclesia, the gathering of believers, dear God. So help us to move from a place where we're just walking into a building to occupy a seat, to listen to someone speak, into that place, dear Heavenly Father, where we get together as one. Moving forward, dear Heavenly Father, in the spiritual realm, things and works that you prepared for us before the beginning of time, and help us to appreciate this place, this moment, each other, the musicians, the pastor, dear Heavenly Father, and even ourselves, because we know some of us, dear Heavenly Father, may be suffering from seasonal depression or any other thing, dear Heavenly Father. But right now, we rebuke it in the mighty name of Christ Jesus. And we pray that spirit of heaviness to break and allow God's people to worship you in spirit and in truth, dear Heavenly Father. Let there be no hindrances today. Let there be no incidents. Let there be no accidents, dear Heavenly Father. But let there only be you at the center of it all. Moving, working, healing, delivering, setting the captive free, and doing things that only you can do. Because we know it's not by our might, it's not by our will, but it's by your power. So we thank you, Father, for all you've done, all you're doing, and all that you will do. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Can we just worship God this morning? Just lift your hands and just worship him. Can we give him a vote of thanks and say, thank you, Lord. Say hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Come on and give God the highest praise. Saints, we are standing here, not by anything that we've done, but because of his grace and his mercy and his goodness is why we praise him. Anybody want to praise God with me this morning? God is good. All the time and all the time, God is good. So we will worship him. For he is faithful and he is awesome and he is true. Hallelujah. We love you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 We love you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. The song says that, Lord, you are good and your mercy endureth forever. Does anybody believe that this morning? They know that we, our Lord is good. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. This morning, we're going to need you to clap your hands. stomp your feet and just be ready to praise God this morning. Hallelujah. Say, Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
Say, Lord, you are good, yeah.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
Say, Lord, you are good.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
Forever and ever, Lord.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
We are your people.
We are your people from every nation. From generation to generation, we worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you for who you are.
Come on, we worship.
We worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you. Good, and your mercy endureth forever.
Say, Lord, you are good, yeah.
Lord, you are good, and your mercy endureth forever.
We are your people.
We are your people from every nation. From generation to generation, we worship you. Hallelujah. We worship you for who you are.
Just lift your hands and worship him this morning.
We worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you for who you are.
We worship you this morning.
We worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. We worship you for who you are. You are good.
Come on, he is so good. So good,
so good. Yes, you are, yes, you are,
yes, you are. Say, you are good.
You are good all the time. All the time, you are good. You are good all the time. All the time, you are good.
You are good.
You are good all the time. All the time, you are good.
You are good.
You are good all the time. All the time, you are good.
We are your people.
We are your people from every nation, from generation to generation. We worship you.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you for who you are.
We worship you.
We worship you. We worship you for who you are.
One more time, just lift your hands. We worship you.
We worship you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you for who you are.
Come on, just worship that and say,
we worship you. Worship you for who you are.
Lift your hands and worship him.
We worship you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you for who you are.
Let's lift that up one more time. Don't think about what he is, just what he is.
We worship you. for who you are,
for who you are,
for who you are,
for who you are,
for who you are.
Say you are good, Lord.
You are good.
Hallelujah.
Somebody bless the name of the Lord. Somebody worship the name of the Lord. Somebody lift up the name of Jesus. Somebody lift up the name of Jesus. If you know that you're standing on the promises of God, let me see you worship the Lord. Let me see you lift those hands and magnify the name of the Lord. If you know that God has been good to you, let me see you give God some praise in this building. The devil doesn't want you to give God praise, but regardless of what is going on in your life, let me see you lift those hands and give God some praise. Give God some glory. Give him the honor. Somebody ought to worship the name of the Lord. We worship a mighty God. We worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, the Lord of light, the Lord of strength, the light of hope, the Lord of peace. And that's why we say that he is our strength, and his strength is unlike any other. There's nothing that can be compared to him. He is God of all gods. And that's why we worship him. Amen, somebody. Strength like no other, strength like no other reaches to me. Oh Lord, oh Lord, you are my strength. Strength like no other, strength like no other reaches to me. Can somebody hear me say you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Say you are strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
You are strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches. Say you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Yeah. Strength like
no other.
Say you are strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches.
It reaches.
I don't know if you're hearing. Can we do that one more time? Say you are my strength.
You are.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
You are strength like no other, God.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches. In the fullness, 'cause in the fullness of your grace, in the power of your name, you lift me up. Can somebody lift up the name of Jesus? You lift me up, 'cause in the fullness of your grace, 'cause in the fullness of your in the power, in the power of your name, you lift me up. Said you lift me up when I'm down, yeah. You lift me up. say you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Say you are strength like no other.
Like no other.
You can't be compared to anyone else. You are God all by yourself.
Like no other.
And it reaches to me. You are strength like no other. You are strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches
to me.
Can I hear everybody say, you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Can you lift those voices and say, strength like no other. Say you are
strength like no other.
And it reaches with a little bit more conviction. Say you are my strength.
You are my strength.
Say you are strength like no other. You are stronger than anyone. And it reaches. And it
reaches to me.
You are.
You are my strength.
You are strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
You are strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches. And it reaches.
Reaches to me.
You are.
Reaches me.
Oh Lord, 'cause in the fullness of and in the power of your name, Jesus, you lift me up. When the devil wanted me to stay down, so you lift me up. Oh Lord, oh Lord. 'Cause in the fullness
of your
and in the power of your name,
in the power of
you lift me, God, from the fiery pit of hell.
You lift me up.
Yeah, yeah. You lift me up. One more time. 'Cause in the fullness,
in the fullness of your grace,
in the power of your name,
you lift me up.
You lift me up. You are my strength. Strength like no other. Oh Lord, strength like no other. Strength like no other reaches to me. You're standing on the strength of the Almighty God. You are my strength. You're my hope, you're my joy, you're my peace.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches. One more time. Say you are. You are my strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Glory to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. This is family prayer time. Praise God. The altar is open for anyone who wants to come and pray. Feel free to come on up. Praise God. We'll pray for you. Anything you're going through or you want us to pray, the altar is open at this time. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Thank you, Brother Jason, Sister Chantel. God is our strength. Hallelujah. In our weakness, He's there. We do not know what the rest of this week hold, but we are here on the first day of the week to bow down and worship. Hallelujah. Thank you for coming on up. Those who are worship online, praise God. Just lift your faith too. You're part of our worship, and God is able to minister to you and bless you as you put your trust in Him. I'm going to ask all of us here, praise God, to pray along. Don't just look around or wonder and talk. Just pray. Even if you say, Lord, have mercy. He understands. We're here to worship Him. Amen? Hallelujah. So let us pray. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before your throne this morning, giving you thanks and praise for spirit life. Lord, we thank you for waking us up this morning, allowing us to be in our right mind and putting our hearts so that we can come into this sanctuary to sing your praise and to bow down and worship you. Help us, oh God, that our worship will not be in vain, but our worship will be true worship from our hearts, oh God. We pray that you will search us and try us. If there's anything that would prevent us from worship you the way you want us to worship, we pray that you will remove it now. All the wandering thoughts, all the Satan attack, oh God, all the destruction, I rebuke it in the name of Jesus. And pray that your presence will get our attention, oh God, and that we will trust you to meet all our needs, oh God, because we know you are our strength in our weakness. You are health in our sickness, oh God. In our sorrow, oh God, your comfort and joy, oh God, in our disappointment, we know that you give us confidence to put our trust in you and know that you will see us through no matter what come our pathway. Your word tells us you will not give us more than what we can bear. And sometimes, Lord, the burden seems so heavy. Seems like we cannot make it. But thank you today that we can come to the throne of grace with these burdens and leave them at the foot of the cross, because we know that you were wounded for our transgression and bruised for our iniquity. All our chastisement was upon you, and by your stripes we are healed. I pray that you'll touch us individually in the name of Jesus. Oh God, may your divine hands take hold of us, oh God, and that we'll feel your presence in this place today. We pray for a supernatural awakening, oh God. I pray that a spiritual star, oh God, for a miracle to take place for your name's sake. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Pray, Lord, for the children. May you protect them and guide them. We pray for the youth, Lord. We pray for all the seniors. We want to pray, Lord, for the widows and the widowers and the homeless, oh God. We know you are loving and caring for them. So we pray, Lord, that you'll just have your own way in this service. May every needs be met. Your source will never be exhausted. Your promise, oh God, that you will meet all of our needs according to your riches and glory by Christ Jesus. So make the way, Lord, for those who are not here today, oh God, those who travel, be with them wherever they are, oh God. Comfort again those who are mourning, loved one. Pray for Brother Lauren's family. We pray for Brother Stewart's family, oh God. We pray that you'll just bless them, oh God. Sister Cheryl's family, we pray for Brother Eben, all those who still going through that time of grief. Those that I may not even know, Lord, you know what they're going through that I failed to call upon you for. We know, Lord, you are able to strengthen us. Again, let your spirit have his way in this service. Have thine own way, Lord. Have your own way. Thou art the potter, we are the clay. Mold us and make us, Father God, after your will, while we'll wait before you yielded and still. Bless the first family of this church. Lord, strengthen them. Cover them and guide them and protect them. All the other families, oh God, even the very last one, dear, maybe those who come in for the first time, I pray, Lord, for your blessing upon them. And those who are coming faithfully, Lord, may we not be disappointed today, Lord, nor be ashamed, but we will come with the assurance that we have met with you, Lord, and what we came for, you have delivered. Once again, pray for those who step forward in the name of Jesus. Whatever the challenge are, my sister, my brother, my sister, oh God, as they stand up in your presence, embrace them, Lord. Give them the strength to meet their needs. Those, oh God, online with their needs, I pray that you will reach out and touch them. Minister to them, oh God. Those in the pew, bowing, Lord, you know all about us. And we want to bring everything to the mercy seat and know that you are help in ages past. And you are our help right now. And we know that you there's no failure with you. So strengthen my sister, my brothers, oh God. And let your spirit continue to move in this place. So that when the service conclude, Lord, we'll all say it was good for us to be here. Because we meet with you and we receive from you what you have in store for us. So once again, Lord, open the windows of heaven and pour out the blessing we pray for today. The blessing we sing for today. The blessing, oh God, we give for today. Let your will be done, we pray. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank Hallelujah. You, thank you. Hallelujah.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Wow, what a powerful move of God. Glory, glory to God. Thank you, God. Good morning, church. Today I have been blessed with a great opportunity to bring before you the word of God and read a scripture. The scripture I'll be reading today is Matthew chapter 25, verse 31 to 46. All right, and I want you to extend a little grace because this is my first time reading publicly to you, FRCC. So I am a little nervous, so pray for me. All right. So just to add a little bit of context to this, it's a parable. And the dictionary Webster defines a parable as a short, simple story illustrating a moral or spiritual truth. So we know Jesus spoke many parables. We hear that from when we were young, but some of us never went and defined a parable. So again, it's a short, simple story illustrating a moral or spiritual truth. So just to give you context of Matthew 25, there are about three parables in that. It's the 10 versions. Everyone knows the 10 version, the wise and the foolish ones with the oil. And then it goes into the parable of the talents. And they gave one talent and so forth, right? And it's one buried, and the ones who used them were blessed, the one who buried were not. So now we get down to 31, which they speak about the judgment. So please stand if you're able to as we enter into the word of God. When the Son of Man shall come in his glory and all the holy angels with him, then shall he sit upon the throne of his glory. And before him shall be gathered all nations, and he shall separate them one from another, as a shepherd divided his sheep from his goats. And he shall set the sheep on his right hand and the goats on his left. Then shall the king say unto them on his right hand, Come, ye blessed of my Father, inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundations of the world. For I was hungered, and ye gave me meat. I was thirsty, and ye gave me drink. I was a stranger, and ye took me in. Naked, and ye clothed me. I was sick, and ye visited me. I was in prison, and ye came unto me. Then shall the righteous answer him, saying, Lord, When saw thee a thirsty? When saw we thee a thirsty and fed thee? Or thirst? Pull up. Lord, when saw we thee a hunger and fed thee? Or thirsty and gave thee drink? When saw we a stranger and took thee in? Or naked and clothed thee? Or when saw we thee sick or in prison and came unto thee? And the king shall answer unto them, Verily I say unto you, insomuch as ye have done it unto one of the least of these my brethren, ye have done unto me. Then shall he say unto them on his left hand, Depart from me, ye cursed, into everlasting fire, prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungered, and ye gave me not meat. I was thirsty, and ye gave me no drink. I was a stranger, and ye took me not in. Naked, and ye clothed me not. Sick, and in prison, and ye visited me not. Then shall they also answer him, saying, Lord, when saw we thee an hungry, or a thirst, or a stranger, or naked, or sick, or in prison, and did not minister unto thee? Then shall he answer them, saying, Verily I say unto you, insomuch as ye did it not to one of the least of these, ye did it not to me. And these shall go into everlasting punishment, but the righteous into life eternal. Blessed be the reading of the word.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Glory be to God. Praise the Lord. I don't know about you this morning, but I am grateful. I am grateful. When I think of the goodness of Jesus, I am grateful. I woke up this morning. And I believe I'm still in my right mind. So I am grateful. Hallelujah. Tell somebody that you love them. Come on. We come here to have church. We come to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We have needs. Tell somebody you love them. And mean it. Come on. Let's break every chain in this place today. Love you, sis. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Who didn't get I love you? I know somebody didn't get it. I tell you, I think I still in my right mind. Oh, bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. Give the Lord a round of applause. Come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. As we sing this song, pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry. Let's open our hearts and let's sing. Let's worship him. Hallelujah. I don't know what you come to do this morning. I'm just talking, but anyway, let's sing the song. Pass me not, O gentle Savior. Hear my humble cry. But calling, do not pass me by. Savior, Savior, hear my humble cry. Hey, oh Lord, here it goes. Help my unbelief. Ah, Savior, glory to God. Savior, hear my humble cry. Ooh, while on others thou art calling, oh, do not pass me by. Trusting only in thy merit. Oh, would I seek thy face? Oh, heal my wounded, broken spirit. Save me by his grace. Yeah. Oh, Savior, glory to God. Savior, hear my humble cry. Why on others thou art calling? Do not pass me by. Thou the spring of all my comfort, oh, more than life to me. Hey, whom have I honored beside? Glory to God. Who in heaven? Who in heaven but thee? And let's sing it. I say, Savior, Savior, oh yeah, my humble cry. Yes, why on others thou art calling? Do not pass. Come on, Savior. Calling. Oh, do not. Come on, let's do it again. Savior, 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 hear my humble cry. Ooh, why on others thou art called? Do not pass. Let me do verse one again. Pass me not. Pass me not, oh gentle Savior. Somebody need to say, come on. Hear my humble cry. Ooh, why on others thou art calling? Do not pass me. Come on, let's sing it out in a one voice. Hey, Savior, Savior, hear my humble cry. Calling. Do we repeat it again? And I want to sing it, but no music. Let's go. Let me hear you. As we say, Savior. Oh, come on. Savior. That's it. Come on. Oh, hear my humble cry. Oh, why run others thou art calling? Oh, do
you want it one more time? Come on. Yes, yeah, somebody take it up. Let's go. As we say, Savior. Oh, Savior. Hear my humble cry. Ooh, why on others thou art calling? Do not pass me by. Hallelujah. Oh, bless the Lord, bless the Lord, bless the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you, God. We worship you, God. We glorify you, God. We worship you, God. We say thank you, Lord. We say thank you, Jesus. We say thank you, Lord. We thank you for the answer this morning. We worship you for the answer this morning. We glorify your name, oh God. We glorify your name, Jesus. We say thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. We worship you, God. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hey. Ooh. Oh, do not pass me by. Hey. Say prayer for me one more time. Savior. Oh, Savior. Hear my humble cry. Ooh, why on others thou art calling? Do not pass me. Do not pass me by, Lord. Do not pass me by. Do not pass me. Don't pass me by today, Lord. Hey, oh, do. Hallelujah. Not, this is your moment. Hey, yes, Lord, just pass by me. But do not pass. Let's worship him. Worship him. Hallelujah. Hey, do not pass me by. Do not pass me. Hey, as I go through this thing, Lord, but do not pass. Hey, hallelujah. Oh, do. Ooh. Do not pass me. Whatever your needs are this morning, he's able. So plead your case. Do not pass me. Plead your case to God this morning. Ooh, oh, oh, do not pass me. Nothing is insurmountable for God. God is able. Do not pass me. Say it prayerfully. He's in the midst to meet your need. Oh, do. Hey. Do not pass me by. Do not pass me by. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God.
Praise the Lord this morning. Hallelujah. Savior. Savior. Hear our humble cry this morning. Lord, we are crying out to you this morning. Thank you, Lord, for being our Savior. We come to this part of the worship service, and we will be picking up today's offering. shall we stand, please? Wonderful Savior is Jesus, our Lord. Father, this morning we come to you, O God, with grateful hearts, O Father. Thank you, God, for taking us through the week, O God, and allow us this morning to come here, Lord, to worship you for who you are, and to praise you, O Father, for your goodness towards us. Your grace and your mercy, O God, have brought us through. And we just want to thank you this morning. And Father, as we bring our challenges to you, crying out to you, O God, we ask, God, for your touch. You a friend, Lord, who stick it closer than a brother. We come to you this morning, and we thank you for providing for us, O God. Thank you, O God, that when things seem so impossible, Lord, we can trust you. Because you are the God of the impossible. You supply needs, O God, when we do not know where it's coming from. Lord, you the way maker, you make a way. You the miracle worker, you are the promise keeper. Great is your faithfulness this morning, O God. Had it not been for you on our side, where will we be? And Father, this morning I pray, O God, your blessing upon your people. Those here in the sanctuary and those, Lord, on whatever platform they are worshiping, O God. We ask, God, that you touch them wherever they are. Let your Holy Spirit saturate those spaces where they are this morning. And move, O God, in a mighty way. Encourage the discouraged this morning. Maybe some don't have anything this morning. But God, we know you promised that you will provide. And so as we bring our offering to you this morning, we ask, God, your blessing upon it. We ask that you multiply it and you give us the wisdom to use it to give you honor, God. We ask that you continue, O God, to bless us as we continue, O God, this mission here on earth here. We ask, God, that you prepare our hearts to receive from your servant, O God. Anoint him, O God, so that he can bring the word with clarity, whatever you have laid upon our heart. Help us not to leave this place the way we came in, but that we will be blessed, and in the end, we will be glad that we are here. Take all the praise, all the glory, and the honor. In Jesus' name, amen.
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let's rejoice and be glad in it. Anybody happy to be here this morning? You didn't thought you had made it this morning, but you're here. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
There was blockages on the way, but you made it. Obstacles in your way, but you made it.
Amen.
That's what we're going to say now to God. That there are so many things in our life that will stop us from being successful. And we didn't know how we made it to where we are now. But the word said that it's not by might nor by power, but by His Spirit. I didn't do it by myself, but it was God who did it for me.
Thank you, Lord.
Yeah. Not knowing I will get through this test, and holding on to faith we know best.
Hallelujah.
See, nothing can catch you by surprise. You've got this figured out, and you're watching us just now. Oh, and when it looked as if we can't win, you robbed us in your arm, then stepped in. Oh Lord, 'cause everything we need you supply. You've got this in control, and now we know that you've made a way. Oh Lord, when our back were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way.
Ooh. You made a way.
You made.
So now we're here, looking back on where we've come from, and because of you and nothing we've done to deserve the love and mercy you've shown. But your grace was strong enough to pick us up, and you
made a way. When our backs were against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made
a way.
You made a way. Against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way.
And we're standing
here only because you made a way. Cause you move mountains and you cause wars to fall. With your power, you perform miracles. There is nothing, no, that's impossible. And we're standing here only because you made. 'Cause you move mountains.
You cause walls to fall with your power. You perform miracles. There is nothing that's impossible, that's impossible. And we're standing here only because you say you move mountains. Oh, you cause walls to fall with your power, Lord. You perform miracles. There is nothing, no, that's impossible. And we're standing here only
because you made.
So you move mountains. You cause walls to fall with your power, Lord. You perform miracles. There is nothing, no. That's impossible. And we're standing here only because you made. And we're standing, and we're standing here only because you made. And we're standing here only because you made. Oh, you made a way. Somebody ought to sing that. Made a way. Can we sing that one more time? Say you made a way. One more time, we say that. You made a way. Don't know how, but you did it. Oh Lord, made a way. Don't know how, but you did it. Yeah.
Made a way.
Said I don't know how. Don't know how, but you did, yeah. Made a way. Don't know how, but you did it. Made. Said I don't know why. Don't know why, but I'm grateful. 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 Don't know how, but I'm grateful. Don't know why, but I'm grateful. Don't know why, but I'm. And we're standing here, yeah. And we're standing here only because you made. And we stand.
And we're standing here only because you made. And we're standing here only because you
say you move mountains, you cause walls to fall with your power, Jesus. You perform miracles, and there is nothing, no, that's impossible. And we're standing here, and it's only because you made. Say you move mountains. Say you cause walls to fall with your power. You perform miracle. There is nothing. No. And we're standing here, and it's only because you made. Said, and we're standing here. And it's only because, not by might, not by power, but we're standing here. And it's only because you, I don't deserve it, God, but I'm standing here. And it's only, I should have been dead, but we're
standing here.
And it's only because you made a way.
Hallelujah. Don't get comfortable.
because it's not business as usual. I announced to you last week about warfare. But I also said that we can be barriers of the enemy's plans. Not knowing that it's right around the corner. Just 3 days into the week, news media declared and announced that Iran is going to get ready to attack Israel. And they did. But I just want everybody to know that the attack on Israel is bigger than Israel. We're looking at the next world war. You have the Hezbollah, Hamas, Iran, Syria, the Houthis. Russia is on the wings. North Korea, China, East versus West. And war has already been declared behind the scenes. And we may be saying, oh, somehow, well, it's in the Middle East. But right now there are missiles, ballistic missiles, that can hit New York, hit California, hit Massachusetts, hit anywhere in the continental USA. Russia already has missiles in outer space that can be triggered from there to America. And everybody is waiting. And like they say, war is in the air. And who is behind it? The devil himself. Satan is behind it. But there's a song that says, Jehovah is his name. Jehovah is his name. He's a mighty warrior, bigger than all the battles that they're going to be fighting. And he's great in battle. So North Korea, Russia, China, Iran and Syria, the Houthis, Hezbollah, Hamas, there's no name that can stand in front of him, because Jehovah is his name. All over the world, all over the world today, all over the world today, in churches across the globe, people are praying because Jehovah is his name. And so we're not going to do different. We're not doing this because others are doing it. We are doing it because we are called upon to do it. We are doing it because we are God's people. 2 Chronicles 7:14 says, if my people, come on somebody, stand up on your feet. It's not business as usual. Will humble themselves. Pray. Somebody say pray. Pray. Seek my face. Somebody say, I want to seek his face. Then turn from their wicked ways. I want to turn from my wicked ways. Somebody say. Then will I hear. How many of you believe that God can hear you right now? How many of you believe that he is waiting to hear you right now? How many of you believe that God is watching to see what his people will do? How many of you believe that God is putting this on you? Mighty warrior, great in battle. Whenever there is trouble, the prophets would call the children of God and they would assemble together and they would pray. Why? Because prayer changes things. We're not praying to impress God. We're praying because God says we should pray. And if we pray, he will hear us. We're going to sing this song. And then every person in this room,
Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name.
Sing it one more time. Hallelujah. How many of you, how many of you, how many of you? How many of you can hear the call? Whenever there is war, President, Prime Minister, King, Queen would call on the subjects to come to war. Whenever there is trouble, God is calling on His people, His soldiers of the living God. That's why He prepares us. We are not dry bones in the desert anymore. We are army, an army of the living God. And the clarion call is out. Who will pray for peace? Who will declare peace? Who will stand against war? Who will call on Jehovah? Who has a faith like the prophet who made the sun stand still? Who is here with the power? Who remembers what Jesus placed on you? Behold, He said, I give you power to walk on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Hallelujah. So if God's people who are called by His name will humble themselves today, be it here, be it in Massachusetts, be it in California, be it in Brooklyn, be it in Queens, be it in the Bronx, wherever, if every child of God will humble themselves and pray and seek His face and turn, then He said, I'm going to hear you, my children. So let Iran rage high. Let North Korea stand by. Let Russia get ready. Let China prepare. Jehovah is His name. Come on, somebody. Give God. Come on, I want everybody to cry out now. Come on. Come on, 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 come on. Come on. Step up like you know Him. Step up like you can feel Him. Step up like you've got Him. Step up like He is Jehovah with the power. Step up like He's in His throne. Step up like He is a mighty warrior. Lift up your voices, ye gates. Lift up your voices, ye gates. Shout to the Lord, all the earth. We declare it stopped. We declare it halted. Yes, Jesus. We declare it non-existent. We declare all rumors and rumors of war under your protection, under your instruction, under your guidance. You are in charge. You are God. And so we call on you. You are Jehovah. Stand against you.
Who is able to stand against our God? Because you are the only King of glory. You're the Lord of hosts. You're the Lord strong and mighty. You are God mighty in battle. You're the Alpha and the Omega. You're the beginning and the end. You're the first and the last.
Word is Lamb. You are holy.
You are in charge.
Holy. Are you Lord God Almighty?
Yes.
Word is Lamb.
You sit high and you look low.
Word is Lamb.
You hold the seven seas. In the palm of your hands.
Alleluia.
And so we summon you. We summon you. We summon you.
For the Lord God Almighty reigns.
Come now.
Alleluia.
Dismantle every plan. Dismantle every situation.
Alleluia.
Tone down every rhetoric.
For the Lord God Almighty reigns.
Bring low those who are high, who seek to do damage.
Alleluia.
Yes, Lord. Somebody start praying now. Somebody start praying now.
Worthy is the
Somebody
Lamb.
Start praying now.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Yes.
Worthy is the Lamb.
One will chase.
Worthy is the Lamb. Worthy is the Lamb.
But two.
Worthy is the Lamb.
Shall put 10,000
in the
fight. You are the Lord.
What is the
You are the Lord. You are God, and there is none other. We know that you are in charge. The East is not in charge. The West is not in charge. It doesn't matter who has and possessed the biggest bombs. They're not in charge. Russia is not in charge. America is not in charge. China is not in charge. Korea is not in charge. Hezbollah is not in charge. Hamas is not in charge. Israel is not in charge. The Houthis is not in charge. Jehovah is in charge. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You hold the seven seas in the palm of your hands. You hold the world and its axis in your hands. So we summon your strength and your power. And we say, intervene. Somebody say, intervene, God. Intervene, Jesus. Yes, have your way. Show the world who you are. Because everybody ought to know who Jesus is. Him. You see, when you call on God for a specific situation and God sees and knows that you genuinely are calling on Him, He will also handle other situations, because then you've got an audience with Him. So He will open the windows and the floodgates of heaven, and He will send legions of angels to do His bidding. And so while the enemy, Satan himself, is sending legions of demons, warmongers, God will send legions, multi-legions of heavenly host. Hallelujah. To put a cramp in the enemy's style. To stop the enemy in his tracks. And with his flaming sword. Hallelujah. Just about now. God is saying, hold a minute. My people are calling. Thank God they're calling. I've been waiting for them to call. I've been waiting for them to trust me. I've been waiting for them to summon me. I've been waiting for them to believe that I can do this. God knows He can, but He wants to know that you know that He can. And so He said, I hear my people calling. Come on and let's do the bidding of my people, because I am Jehovah. So we come against fear. Come against timidity. Come against frustration. We come against stress. We come against hypertension, blood pressure. We come against everything that the enemy will use this situation to throw on us. And so we come against it in the name of Jesus, because our God is a God of peace. He said, my peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world give, because the world can't give you peace. All the world can give is heartaches and troubles. But I'm giving you my peace. My peace that surpasses every understanding. My peace that will shock you. My peace that people can't understand. My peace that will show up when there is war. My peace that will show up when there is contention. My peace that will show up when there's a fight. My peace that will show up
in darkest night
when there's a need
you
for peace.
Close like no other.
Hallelujah.
I know you as a father.
And even though the world may be scared, even though the world may be fighting, even though there may be wars, you still have that peace that surpasses. Everybody says, well, how come you're so strong? How come you take it so calm? He said, I give you peace.
Because all my life you have been faithful.
Yes.
And all my life you have been so good.
And he's
so
still good. He's still good.
Every breath that I am in.
The world may be on the brink of blowing up, but guess what?
I will say,
he's still good.
Of the goodness of God. All my life.
All my life you have been faithful.
God is looking for his children, for his people to find goodness in some bad things. You gotta look for his goodness. You gotta find his goodness.
Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Come on.
When my life laid out, I surrender now. I give you everything. Oh yeah. Your goodness is running after. Is running after me. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Hallelujah.
I will sing.
How many of you in this room
of the goodness
would want to know that you would have made a difference today with the calamity of the world?
Of God,
if you're in here
I will sing,
and you want to make a difference, if you want God to hear your voice, if you want him to look down and see you in front of him,
I will sing.
And his people who has been waiting on, people who are called by him, to humble themselves and pray. People who's been waiting on even now to seek his face. They say, while you're at it, while you're calling on me, turn from your wicked ways in the meantime. He said, then they would have fulfilled the requirements for me to answer their prayers. Here's what I'm gonna do. Spirit is saying, be bold, be strong. I need everybody to dress down. Everybody, come down, come down, come down, come down. Because you're making room for others who are coming. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. And if you're standing there, God wants you here. Come on, come on. Make a difference. Hallelujah. This is your life-changing contribution to the children of God. To God himself. All over the world today, churches are dedicating their services to praying. And we're not doing that just because everybody else is doing it. We're doing it because that's what he called us to do. So if you've never prayed to God or challenged God on anything, God wants you to. Because that's how he works. But before we started praying for a halt to war, we're going to start praising him with our hands up. Come on. Come on. As loud as you can. Just praise him. Just praise him. Don't stop praising him. Come on. Just praise him. Jehovah is his name. Just praise him. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands.
All my life you have been is so good.
We bless your name, God.
Every
we summon you, God,
I am
to
earth.
I will not Venus, not Mars, not Pluto, not Uranus. We summon you to earth. In the Middle East,
all
not in the Milky Way,
you have been
in the Middle East, right now.
Cause all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing
some of the good
things.
I need somebody just to get out of yourself now.
You have been
forget about everything else now. Come on. Get to that moment. I need a focus. On
all
God
my
now.
Life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Come on.
Faithful. Oh,
no.
All my life you have been so good. So good. Every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God.
Somebody pray.
With my life laid down,
who's
I surrender
praying?
Now.
Who's praying?
I give you everything.
Who's summoning oh, God?
Your goodness is running after. Is running after me.
Who has the boldness to
your
make the
goodness
sun
is
stand
running
still?
After. Is running after me. Your goodness is running after. Is running after. With my life laid down, I surrender now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after, is running after me.
How many of you believe?
All my life you have.
How many of you know that if God can part the Red Sea, He can stop a war. How many of you know that if God can bring water out of a dry rock, He can stop a war? He'll do what he has to do. If he has to send legions, he will. If he has to confuse the enemy, he will. If he has to make the sun stop, he can and he will. Somebody said, God, we know you're there. Come on, shout it. God, we know you're there. We know you can move. We know you will move. We know you wanted us to cry unto you. God, we know you want us to pray. God, we know You want us to humble ourselves. God, we know you want us to seek your face. God, we know you want us to turn from our wicked ways. And God, we know that you will hear from us. You will forgive our sins. And you will heal the earth. You will heal our land. You will heal Far Rockaway. You will heal Queens. You will heal the subways. You will heal New York City. You will heal Massachusetts. You will heal California. You will heal Iran. You will heal Iraq. You will heal Hamas. You will heal Israel. You will heal North Korea. You will heal China. You will heal Russia. You will heal our land. Hallelujah. Because Jehovah is your name. You are I am that I am. Worship him. Just worship him. Come on. Let's worship him. Let's worship him. Let the beauty of Jesus be seen in you now. Services dedicate to God, to your power and to your might.
Jehovah Nissi, Lord, you reign in victory. Jehovah Shalom, you're my Prince of Peace, and I worship you. You're my provider.
Jehovah Nissi.
Jehovah Nissi. Lord, you reign in victory. Jehovah Shalom.
You're my Prince of Peace.
You're my Prince of Peace.
Yes, he is.
And I worship you.
Come on.
Because of who you are, my provider, Jehovah Nissi.
You're my Prince of Peace.
Lord, you reign in victory. Jehovah Shalom.
So whenever there's, when God summoned his people, he would have them call on him in prayer first. And then he would say praise with a timbrel. What we're going to do, we're just going to pray. No music. No keyboard. No drums. Just pray. Just voices. Come on, come on, come on. Lift those voices, come on. Yes, 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 yes. Lift those voices. Yes, yes, lift those voices. Let's agree, let's agree, let's agree, let's agree. Yeah. Let your prayers be a trigger for somebody else to get to God. Come on, come on. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. No bones about it. No mistakes. No agenda. No nothing. Just praying to God, seeking His audience. Breaking down strongholds. Diminishing the strength and the attack of the enemy. And standing boldly before the throne of grace. Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Bless your name, Jesus. Thank you. Show yourself amongst us now. Manifest yourself amongst us now. Touch somebody and everybody will know that you've touched that person. Heal somebody and everybody will know that you've healed that person. Oh, reveal yourself to somebody in the name of Jesus. Touch, anoint somebody in the name of Jesus. Anoint somebody next to somebody in the name of Jesus. Let your beauty be seen on somebody in the name of Jesus. Let your power be manifested on somebody in the name of Jesus. Let those who stand before you stand in power. Those who stand before you stand in might. Those who stand before you stand in victory. Those who stand before you stand in anointing. Those who stand before you stand in healing. Hallelujah. Thine the glory. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. 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 Father, we bless your children. We thank you for answered prayers. We believe you that we pray to you, you will answer. We have sought your face. We have turned from our wicked ways. We have, you've forgiven our sins. Now heal our lands. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Amen. 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 You may be seated. Come on. Give God praise, somebody. Now everybody needs to claim the peace that God has given us. Claim that peace. Reach out and grab that peace. Peace that the world can't give and nobody can take away. Let's tarry for our sister while she waits for her breakthrough. Give God praise. Put your hands together for her. Cheer her on. Cheer her on. Cheer her on. Because God is moving and he's moving by his spirit. So we say, move, God, move. That's what church is about, that when God can move in somebody's life. That's why we're here. We sing that song, I'm thine, O Lord. Come on. Somebody. How many of you believe that we've made a difference? You, God's people, you've made a difference. And there's a song that says, I've recognized the voice. I've understood the call. Recognize the voice that draws me near. There's a voice that drew you here today. Because he wanted you to stand in the gap. Yes. He wanted you, his people, to make a difference. Every person who prayed, every person who stand against war and warfare, you've made a difference in the kingdom of God. Give God praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon, church. What a move of God. Someone give the Holy Spirit a round of applause. I don't know about you, but since Resurrection Sunday, it's been a crescendo of the Spirit. Am I alone? Am I the only one who feels that? Raise your hand if you feel that. It's been... I like to take notes like on my daily life to see how I could like improve my life, you know. And one of the things that I do is I have like a notepad for FRCC. And one of the things that I wrote today is, you know, after Resurrection Sunday, we should have a special occasion to try to get the house as packed as Resurrection Sunday. But I believe this week was a special occasion. All right. So we're going to read some announcements. If you have the slides for the announcements, we could bring them up. All right, so let's see. We have Sunday school. Each and every Sunday at 10 a.m., we have Sunday school for children and adults. Sunday school does not mean only babies. Age does not define how much you know about church or Jesus. All right, so all ages are welcome. I was an adult convert, and when I got saved, I read the baby Bible first just so I could understand what was going on. And you continue to move. So please do not feel afraid or ashamed of anything. Even when I wanted to become a member of FRCC, I sat with Pastor Reed. Trust me, it's worth it. Don't play with your spiritual life or because of pride why you don't go to Sunday school. So 10 a.m., please come to Sunday school, all right? All right. All right. Do remember, as I spoke about, if you want like a new membership class, a lot of us are not members as yet, not a lot, but there are some people that are not members yet that visit us often. If you want to become a member of FRCC, which is, by the way, totally awesome, please join us for Sunday morning at 10 a.m. and see our pastors or ushers for more information, please. Pastors, some of us may not know who you are other than Reverend Mullins. Please, the pastors, raise their hands. Please, look. All right, Pastor Johnson. All right, Pastor Stanley and Pastor Reed and Pastor Mullins, but usually you could check the ushers, all right? All right, next one. We also have prayer and fast each and every Monday. That is a tremendous time, a wonderful time of God, led by Pastor Reed, each and every Monday from 10 a.m. until 2 p.m., correct? 10 a.m. till 2 p.m. Sometimes I get a lunch hour and I sneak out and enjoy my little 45-minute break in prayer. It's a beautiful time. Trust me, God moves, God breaks through. All right. Do remember the prayer and devotional call each and every Wednesday at 12 noon. All right. You can call in the conference number and the access code is on the stream. And that's led by Pastor Stanley and Pastor Reed as well. All right. Beautiful time. Call in 12 p.m. And then we have devotional prayer call led by the woman each and every Saturday at 7:30 a.m. Has anyone been fortunate enough to join that call? Raise your hand. Let's see. See, look at that. So don't think, oh, I'm going to be the only one that calls in. Because I've noticed that a lot of time, people don't want to be the first ones to do something. So if they figure, well, I don't want to call because no one else is calling in, but there are people that call in. So do not be ashamed. Do not be shy. No one's going to call you out and say, oh, is this your first time? And make you feel funny. Just call. Call, be mute, and listen, and pray, and join in one. Amen? Amen. And the prayer walk. I don't know about you, but I've sensed just that move of prayer. God calling us to pray. Even for the last couple of weeks, it's just been a theme of prayer, an atmosphere of prayer. And this was planned before any of this started to happen. But please, we're inviting you next Saturday, April 27th at 11 a.m. We're going to meet here at 11 a.m. Right? Yeah, look. And then we're going to be making 5 stops along the way. And then we're going to come back here to wrap things up. We have light refreshments, right? And anyone feel like bringing something for, you know, eat or drink, just please see me at the end and we could coordinate that as well. And as the Spirit led me this week, he said, how about those who don't feel they're mobile enough to walk that long territory? Still come here, because you could stay here, station here, and pray. We'll also have tracks. We're working on tracks to give out to the community as well. Right, so you could stay here, you could pray, you could help set up the refreshments, you could give out tracts in front of the church. Please, do not feel like you're too young or too seasoned to come to the prayer walk. We're going to have something to do for everyone, all right? And wait, go one quick thing, go back to the prayer walk. So last week, we had quite a few people scan this code and sent us their information. We'll be contacting you shortly. But if you have not done so as yet, could you take your phone out, and scan this QR code? This is called a QR code. When you scan it, a URL will come up. You click the URL, and then you could pre-fill the form, all right? And join us on the prayer walk, all right? Next. One of the most elegant events that we have all year, this is the big annual Mother's Day dinner. Round of applause for our First Lady for putting this together. Thank you so much. So please remember, Saturday, May 4th at 5 p.m. It's only $40 per person. And trust me, you're going to get way more than $40 worth. You know how FRCC does it. Always over the top. So please be there Saturday, May 12th at 5 p.m. Young ones, if you want to have a Mother's Day gift, but you don't really know what to do, this is it, all right? This is it. And do remember, we have Daniel at Sight and Sound, and that's happening June 29th, 2024. And teens and adults are only $240, and children 3 to 12 is $140. Your payments are due. All outstanding monies are due. So please, wave your hand real quick. See our sister right here, and you could just, all right? Has anyone ever been to Sight and Sound before? Look at that. So if you've been before, tell a friend to tell a friend and come and enjoy. So you get live animals. Google it. All right, and then these are our events. You could take a picture, and we have Vocational Bible School, VBS, August 12th to the 16th, Vocational Bible Study. And I believe that's all for the announcements. Thank you so much for Rockaway Community Church of the Nazarene. We have flyers back there for the prayer walk. So on your way out, if you could take 3 flyers, give it to 2 friends, save one for yourself. Also, feel free to scan, send out the QR code. And thank you.
Thank you, Dale. So, by the way, the flyers for the VBS, this is going to be a really fascinating program. It's a great program. I looked at it. It's really, really outstanding. Thanks to Sister Savine for her great work in developing that. And so please get your children out and your neighbors and anybody else, you know, with children. This is an upgrade from our regular VBS. So please be part of that. Also, the flyers and the cards for the prayer walk is also, they're also outside. So grab one, take them, give them to your neighbor and your friends. And finally, before you leave, you could stop by upstairs for some lunch. And I'm pleased to say it's ready this time. I know it's not just the dish that you had last time, but I think the soup that you always grab at the front, now you have to go upstairs to get it this time. Oh, Pastor Reed, tell me you was going to put it upstairs. Just. So the funds for, not only the funds for Sight and Sound's due, not only the outstanding funds due for Sight and Sound, but it's also due for Mother's Day. So if you have the Mother's Day money, cough it up. Okay, you have something more, Dale?
Oh, yes. We have, when on April 28th, coming at 11 a.m., Chosen Initiative with World Vision. World Vision is going to do something big and something great. We couldn't pull the video today, but we do have a video to show you soon.
When do you want to comment on that or no? Wendy?
Yeah. April 28th at 11 a.m.
So everybody can, you know, we still have food upstairs, so you don't have to go far to. So we have a little time here.
Good afternoon, everyone. Hope you are blessed today. So World Vision is partnering with Far Rockaway Church of the Nazarene. You guys are well aware of how we used to do child sponsorship, and we used to do it through the Nazarene Church, and we would collect monies and we, you know, send it out for 1 year to get one child sponsored. So this is a little different. World Vision is doing it where they actually have the kids choose us. And we're going to show the video next week where we come together, we're planning with them. On April 28th, they will come out. They're going to have people from World Vision here. They're going to try to get everyone to participate. We're going to set up in the back. We're going to have a photo booth. Now, if you want to sponsor a child, it's $39 a month. You don't have to do it long term, but it'll be nice if we participate. We're looking forward to it. They're going to set up the photo booths. You can take as individual or with a family. So say Pastor Reed wants to sponsor a child with his family. He can go. They're going to go there, take pictures together, and all the pictures will be sent to the families. We're going to be sponsoring children from Burundi in Africa. And what they will do, they'll send the picture to them, and they're going to have a party for them to be able to choose who they want. So they'll see all of our pictures, and they see the families and, you know, everybody together. Once they see it, they will go and they'll say, okay, I want that person to be my sponsor. And once they are chosen, they'll put it back in the little envelope that says chosen, send it back to us. And then the following Sunday, we will get to see who it is that chose us. So that's pretty much how it works. But more information will be given next week. And it's really, really nice. I'm not going to lie, I watched the video and just seeing the kids, like, watching, you know, like, so anxious to see who they're going to get to choose. It was really exciting. And the whole idea is we're over here and we don't know what others are going through. And we take advantage of things that they don't have. So if, you know, we can find our hearts to work together and be able to sponsor these kids, it would be really helpful. Again, next week you'll have all the information, okay?
Thank you so much. Do we have any first-time visitors, anyone visiting with us for the first time? If you could quickly raise your hand, please. Don't be shy. Don't be shy. Round of applause. Round of applause. Usher, if you could please say our brother. Thank you so much for joining us today. Out of all the churches in Far Rockaway, we're happy you chose us. And a very special occasion. We're celebrating some birthdays today, people. We're celebrating Brother Carlos Samuels, Sister Melissa Williams, Brother Kristen Batten, and Reverend Samuel Reed. A round of applause for everyone celebrating a birthday today. Thank you so much. And now our closing prayer.
Okay, blessings, blessings, blessings. Happy birthday to all of you. Happy birthday, Pastor Reed. You don't look a year older than 16. Let's all stand. Let's all stand. Thank you for reminding me. This weekend, from the Thursday through Saturday, we will have our annual district assembly, the 114th district assembly. And we are looking forward to that. We will. So it's an exciting time because we'll be choosing a new superintendent. So we're looking forward to that. So keep that in prayer as we celebrate this coming weekend. Bow your heads as we dismiss. Father, we thank you today for the time we spent in your presence. We thank you, Lord, for allowing your children, your people, to stand in the gap. We pray now that you will just boost and empower us as we become bold to fight the good fight of faith and to stand up against warfare and evil in the name of Jesus. Now unto you who is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before your throne with exceeding great joy. You're the only wise God, to whom be honor, glory, majesty, dominion, and power. May your rest remain and abide with us both now and forever. Amen. Give God some praise. Put your hands together. Thank you for coming.